I saw a headline today that absolutely stopped me in my tracks. Let's get right into it. Researchers expose zero-day clickjacking vulnerabilities in major password managers. All right, this combines a lot of my interests. Clickjacking, long history with that and AppSec. Password managers and browser extensions is what I'm guessing they're attacking here. As I keep saying, I can't stop talking about extension security. So they're saying hacker demonstrates how easy it is to steal data from popular password managers. Pretty carefully worded headline, steal data, not steal passwords. So this was on Socket's blog, but they're linking out to a Defcon talk. This just happened in Vegas like a week and a half ago, put out by Merrick Toth. Sorry if I mispronounced that. So let's get into his highlights, the key information that he talks about here. He selected 11 password managers to test this that are used for specifically as browser extensions, and all of them were vulnerable to this new DOM-based extension clickjacking thing that this researcher found. This isn't just your traditional clickjacking. If you don't know what clickjacking is, I'll get to it in 1 second. Oh, the other interesting part of this entire video is a lot of these password managers are choosing to not fix this vulnerability, which makes this a very interesting conversation. So these are all like the major password managers. They're saying a single click anywhere on the attacker site could leak credit card details. This is pretty standard clickjacking, but I didn't know what this whole DOM-based extension clickjacking thing is that he's saying is kind of new. So all password managers filled the credentials not only to the main domain, but also to subdomains. This is an interesting part. So if an attacker could find cross-site scripting, even on subdomains, which if you're familiar with bug bounty hunting or AppSec at all, cross-site scripting is way more common on random subdomains that the security team might not even be aware of. This is why attack surface management and recon is like a big part of identifying these vulnerabilities. But sometimes those subdomains don't have access to the same like level of information as the main domain. They're saying in this attack, if you even found cross-site scripting on a subdomain, if you had autofill turned on for your password manager for just that main domain, you could steal the credentials out of the password manager here. And even in most of them, pass keys could be stolen out because people are storing their pass keys in their password managers. All the vulnerabilities were reported back in April. The DEFCON talk was obviously in August, and a bunch of the vendors have decided to not fix the vulnerability. I spotted this back on the Socket blog when I first saw the headline, said, hey, here are the password managers that are impacted. Bitwarden, 1Password, LastPass, LogMeIn, EndPass, and Apple's iCloud password. And this little parenthetical on the end of each of them is what caught my attention. Latest, you can't even update your way out of this vulnerability. The update just a few hours ago, literally in between the time that I was choosing to make this video and now that I'm recording it, Bitwarden announced that they do have a mitigation that's shipped, but 1Password is claiming that a lot of the mitigations outlined in this research at DEFCON are easily bypassable. We're going to get to that. This is important to the whole thing. So really quick, what the hell is clickjacking? The gist of it is this opacity feature. So you could make an iframe. This is like traditional clickjacking. You can make an iframe. You can make the opacity zero, basically see through completely hidden iframe. And then you could put it over a visible element on the screen. The user thinks they're clicking the visible element. They're actually clicking the invisible thing in the iframe. And the mechanism in password managers that's under attack here is this autofill feature, right? So when you go to a page with that's a known domain that the password manager recognizes, they will autofill the credentials or the credit card or whatever it is into the forms. So you can see in his POC, he makes like a fake Cloudflare CAPTCHA type thing to get you to click. You click it. Maybe some of these attacks take more than one click, so there could even be like a more complicated CAPTCHA that could pop up. To steal a whole bunch of information out of the vault, I think it took 4 clicks to steal just one thing. It took 1 click. So he's demonstrating, hey, pretty easy to get someone to click on my fake thing for a bunch. And in this video, what you can't see, I don't know why the video is broken for the opacity of 0.5. What you can't see is for each of those clicks, there's an invisible floating box above it that I think was probably in this demo that for some reason has stopped working. He got a $10,000 bounty for this vulnerability. So his new attack is this DOM-based extension clickjacking. So I think this iframe stuff has been around a gazillion years. Not new to anyone, right? But this DOM-based stuff is where the extensions come in. So browser extensions inject elements into the DOM themselves, and the attacker can then make those invisible using JavaScript. So if you use a password manager, you're probably familiar with what this looks like. You go to a login form, the password manager injects this overlay into the DOM to say, hey, do you want to like fill in your password here. And this is the thing he's proving. So here's what it normally looks like. Here's at like half opacity and then zero opacity. So this is completely hidden here. So in his POC, he shows like the accept reject cookie type thing. He had a fake login form. Now he's got the fake password filler over here. And when you click reject cookies, you're actually giving him the data, right? So, okay, reject. Here's the login form, make it invisible. Here's the password manager thing, make it invisible. And then when the user clicks, you can steal those clicks. That's the gist of it. He obviously goes into way more depth about the research than we really need to get for the purposes of this video. But needless to say, this graph is pretty scary. Basically, all the password managers that you've heard of are vulnerable to this type of attack. But why are some of them choosing to not fix it? So for that, we're gonna go back to the Socket blog. They talked to 1Password a bit. And this is a long known issue. 1Password actually has a carve out in their bug bounty program that says, please do not report clickjacking for the autofill action. We know about it. 1Password comes out and says, this is a known and commonly reported issue. Nobody is denying that there is potential for clickjacking. We understand that the presence of XSS vulnerabilities can potentially increase the impact of clickjacking attempts to go from just like that credit card autofill to the actual username and password stealing. This is a general security principle that applies universally. It's not unique to our application. Our stance is that if a user visits a vulnerable website that is outside of our control, just like if a user visits a malicious website or has a compromised device. This is a great point. Cross-site scripting kind of trumps mitigations for a lot of security vulnerabilities. I've run bug bounty programs for major websites before. I've participated in finding bugs. If you find a CSRF bug and you're going to report that that bug is actually only vulnerable if there's also cross-site scripting on the website, it's like, yeah, of course. If the attacker can execute their JavaScript on my website, they can grab CSRF tokens. Got it. 1Password goes on their support page to say techniques like clickjacking or deceptive overlays can be used to trick users into interacting with interface elements, including autofill prompts, in a way that may expose sensitive information. For maximum safety, consider keeping the 1Password browser extension locked while browsing unfamiliar websites. Yeah, if you're highly paranoid, don't use the browser with your vault in it when you're doing whatever the heck you're doing. Okay, fair. So they're saying here, protecting against clickjacking in the presence of XSS or subdomain takeover is a valuable defense in-depth strategy the password manager extension should implement. We're calling on 1Password, LastPass, EndPass, iCloud passwords, and LogMeIn to better protect users because Dashlane, NordPass, ProtonPass, and Keeper, and I think Bitwarden in progress, have implemented these mitigations. But Socket, in discussing this with 1Password, has some relevant information to that decision. On the call between 1Password and Socket, 1Password explained that the mitigations proposed could be trivially bypassed. I don't have a lot more information about how, but I tend to trust the security team here that are experts in this particular mitigation. The only way to mitigate the vulnerabilities fully would be to implement a dialog pop-up to prompt the user before autofilling. It's in the opinion of Socket security team that if this is the case, the mitigations currently implemented by all the other password managers may be bypassable. And then here's the crux of the conversation I thought worthy of making a video about. Security and usability, this is from 1Password. Security and usability are a balance, one that we are always making trade-offs back and forth to find the right solution. Sometimes there's no perfect solution, only the solution that works best for the most users. As I mentioned previously, it is only with user feedback that we chose to remove the prompt for PII items that would prevent clickjacking from occurring. Basically, they had a prompt that fixed this, and enough users complained about it, they got rid of it. A change that we've documented in the support article under identity alerts. I think that's a well-reasoned, well-thought-out, well-articulated position to take. There isn't a vulnerability in 1Password or any of these other password managers and their implementation. The vulnerability would be in some website that the user was tricked into going to and clicking on a fake CAPTCHA or an exploitation of another cross-site scripting vulnerability. Again, not in these password managers themselves. It's hard to disagree with that. It's well thought out. So if you're actually really paranoid about this, one thing that you could do yourself instead of waiting on them to do anything, because it seems like, you know, their decision's probably made that this is a trade-off of usability versus actual risk reduction, is you could just disable this autofill feature yourself. You could just copy and paste only in your thing. Me personally, not losing enough sleep over this one. I don't think the risk is high enough for me falling for one of those fake CAPTCHAs. Not that I'm like good at spotting those things better than the average bear or anything like that. I just think the risk is low enough. And I actually value my password manager autofilling on the site that I expect it to as a protection from phishing things. I've actually had that happen where I've landed on a phishing site before. I noticed that my password manager did not autofill or didn't even suggest to autofill on that domain. And I went, oh crap, this is a fake domain. So that has absolutely happened before. Not that I would have logged in, but it was a signal to me to investigate what domain I was on further. So they're saying set only the exact URL match for autofill credentials. I do have this turned on. They're saying, hey, this is only protection against the credential part. This is not protection against the credit card or other PII, like if you do your address autofill or credit card autofill. I don't think I have autofill turned on for credit card or address or anything like that. But yeah, what do you think about this one? Do you agree with 1Password's stance? I tend to, especially if they have some information that they haven't put out of that this is actually all the mitigations that are supposedly in place by the other password managers are bypassable. I'd love to see some more information about that. Do you have any more information about that? If you're watching this, please let me know below. And then yeah, leave a comment. Do you agree? Is this a serious enough vulnerability that you would consider changing password managers from one who took a stance saying that they, you know, aren't gonna take the usability hit to mitigate this? I don't know. Kudos to the researcher. Kudos to 1Password for getting back to Socket with that well thought out response. We can at least have the conversation now if we agree or disagree with you. I think that stance is perfectly reasonable by 1Password to take, by the way. Thank you for Socket for reaching out to all of them and digging in beyond the DEFCON presentations research. And yeah, if you found this useful, please share it all around. Share it with your team. Share it with your mom. Moms love me. Click all the buttons below. Help me grow this YouTube channel as I get it off the ground. Thank you very much.